Now, I've done something so bloody I shouldn't tell you about it. But I will. I caught a wild pig. Then I chopped down the door of the cabin and I slit the pig's throat. Then I spilled pig's blood all over everything so that they'd think somebody broke in and murdered me. Ooh, I throwed in all the fancy touches. Tom Sawyer couldn't have done it better himself. And as Tom always said, a man's best friend is a hog.
Well, I always heard, but I ain't too sure, that a man's best friend is a mangy cur. I kind of favor the hog myself, about a hand for the hog. You see, a hog ain't nothing but a porky thing, they porky feet and a nosy ring. Tickle them feet, folks, how about a hand for the hog? If you took a notion, I bet a good dog would make a hell of a pet. You could teach him to ride and hunt, you could clean him up, let him still run.
Then I got some fish hooks, a spyglass, some matches, and some coffee, and headed off to Jackson's Island in Pap's canoe.
Well, in the scheme of things, the way things go, you might get bit by the old Fido. Not that gentle porker friend, though. How about a hand for the hog? Fellow and a hog at a comedy act. That fellow was terrible, as a matter of fact. That hog was a funny sucker, though. How about a hand for the hog? If you took a notion, I bet you could teach a hog to smoke a cigarette. Well, it might take a little bit of time, but hell, what's time to a hog? The way I see it, looks like this. In any way, or either you is, but a true bull lover of swine, folks. How about a hand for the hog? Thank you.
The sky looks ever so deep when you look up in the moonlight. And everything was dead quiet. And it looked late and smelt late. Know what I mean? Just me and the drift logs and the moon. When I got to Jackson's Island, I was tired. Sort of lonesome. Well, there ain't no better way to put in time when you're lonesome than to sleep. You can't stay so, you soon get over it. So I slept for the better part of 3 days. I was woke by this deep boom. I see through my spyglass a ferry boat crossing the river. They was firing off a cannon to make my body rise to the top, and floating loaves of bread loaded with quicksilver, because they're supposed to go right to a dead carcass and stop. That's how I'd know. My plan had worked and they thought I was dead. There's Pap and Judge Thatcher and the Widow Douglas and Miss Watson. There's Ben Rogers and Joe Harper and Tom Sawyer. Ooh, the look on their faces.
Huckleberry! Huckleberry!
But when they was gone, I felt kind of lonesome again. So I decided to explore the island. I was the boss of it. It all belonged to me, so to say. And I got to thinking, here was a place where a body didn't have to be nobody but himself. I, Huckleberry me, somewhere sitting underneath some tree, somewhere maybe fishing, or maybe someplace sitting just wishing I was fishing. Oh, I, Huckleberry me, hereby declare myself to be nothing ever other than exactly what I am. And I'll never change for no one, no matter what they say. If I want to smoke in church, I'll smoke. If I want to pray, I'll pray. Oh, I, Huckleberry me, do hereby declare myself to be ever other than exactly what I am. Ooh, dead skunk, probably for curing warts. And I'll never change for no one, no matter what they say. If I want to go to school, I'll go. If I wanna stay away, I'll stay. Oh, I, Huckleberry me, to be. Nothing ever other than exactly what I am. Nothing ever other than exactly what I am.